A policeman wanted in connection with the forced drowning of a man in Bambalapitiya surrendered to the police today. The body of the man who drowned after being attacked and forced further into the sea in Bambalapitiya was found Friday morning. According to media reports, the Colombo Crimes Division is investigating the incident. The assault and drowning took place amidst onlookers on Thursday. Deputy Finance Minister says the government may intervene if private banks fail to reduce interest rates in the future. However, he said rates of private banks will come down gradually without government intervention.
මේ බැංකු පද්ධතියට අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම සිද්ධ වෙනවා මේ කියන සහනදා සහනයන් පෞද්ගලික අංශයකට දෙන්න. මේ අවසාන දේ ගැන තමයි මම කිව්වේ එතනට එන්නේ නැත්නම් අපිට මුදල් මණ්ඩලය මගින් යම් කිසි නිර්ණායකයන් මේකෙන් අදහස් කරන්නේ නැහැ පෞද්ගලික බැංකු ටික වැහැලා යන තීන්දුව අපි ගන්නවා කියලා. මේ යම් යම් නිර්ණායකයන් අපිට ගන්න පුළුවන් වේවි ඉදිරියේද. නමුත් මම විශ්වාස කරන්නේ නැහැ එතෙන්ට අපිට යන්න වේවි කියලා. ඊට පෙර මේ තියෙන සුවිශේෂී තරඟයත් එක්ක මේ රටේ බැංකු පද්ධතියටම මේ කියන තැනට අනුගත වෙන්න වේවි කියන එක තමයි මගේ කල්පනාව.
Meanwhile, the UNP claims that the sudden reduction of lending rates is an election tactic and the government has not thought of the losses the banks could suffer. Minister Rajitha Senaratna says unlike Ceylon Petroleum Corporation workers, the military demanded nothing during the battle against the LTT and that was the key reason that led to the defeat of terrorism.
Petroleum Corporation employees asking for 5,000 rupees salary increase.
Right. So then what the soldiers will ask? They sacrifice their lives, they sacrifice their limbs, they sacrifice their families, they sacrifice their children for the sake of the future of this country. Right? If they also stayed at Kilinochi and said, if we are not paid 10,000 rupees by tomorrow, we will not march forward.
What would have happened to the country?
The final battle, the Mulati, if they asked for 50,000 salary increase, we had to pay. No problem. Right? That is how we have won the battle. They are asking nothing from us. Right? They did everything. The last 10 days, 5,000 soldiers were killed and we gained freedom.
He was speaking at the inauguration ceremony of Sri Lanka's first ever international construction trade fair titled XCON 2009. The event will focus on promotion and export of construction-related professional services and contracting capacities in the competitive global market.
For the last 13 years, they are battling with all the sophisticated weapons, with all the mighty powers, the America, the Germany, France, Japan, UK, all. Soldiers are all the groups are marching. What is the result? Nothing. Defeated. Right? Defeated. They are withdrawing their troops. Right? All those countries never gave us one bullet for us to fight this terrorism. They preach so many things. They write articles with millions of words. How to defeat terrorism. How to defeat international terrorism. Right? They never gave $1 to us. Right? Only one or two countries helped us. But we marched forward. We won it. Everybody said, no, cannot. What their advice was only, stop the war. Go for discussion. Prabhakaran is a military genius. You can never defeat.
Sri Lanka is to import 50,000 metric tons of rice as a buffer against what the government calls an artificial shortfall of rice in the future.
We are not importing. Please don't misunderstand. What we are doing is, even now we are not importing a single kilo of rice. But if there is an eventuality, right, we are going to have a buffer stock in Sri Lanka. We have done it last year. We will do it next year. Next year also build the buffer stock. Why are we having a buffer stock? To mitigate the prices. The paddy market, the prices will, we want to remain it as it is. For the last 3 years, we managed to keep the paddy rice, kilo of rice for that particular amount.
Sri Lanka's rice is not of export quality and prices are kept high in the country by restricting cheaper foreign rice. There are also taxes against other carbohydrate substitutes like potatoes and wheat.
Now we are quietly introducing machinery, technology, so that the yield can go up. Once the yield can go up from the present levels, definitely prices will come down. Sri Lanka, the government intervention is necessary, my dear. That is what we are doing. That is how we save the country from the brink of collapse in certain places. Right? So that's a type of an incentive that we are giving to people.
The Air Force Seva Vanita unit awarded scholarships to 51 children of war heroes killed and disabled in action at a ceremony held at the Air Force headquarters today. The Air Force said 20 interest-free housing loans worth 2 million rupees were granted to serving personnel and their families. Wheelchairs were also donated to the disabled. The Air Force says it has around 300 disabled personnel. The Met Department says there will be showers at times in the eastern, Uwar and north central provinces. Thunder showers will develop at most places during the afternoon or night. There may be temporarily localized fairly strong winds during thunder showers. The general public is requested to take precautions to minimize damages caused by lightning.